Hello friends, today we are going to read Guru and Pichu's Day Out. The author is Meenu Thomas, the illustrator is Sayan Mukherjee, and the publisher is Pratham Books. So let's read Guru and Pichu's Day Out. So who are Guru and Pichu? Can you see them in this picture? So this is Guru and this is Pichu, his dog. Let's see what they did on their day out. Guru and Pichu the dog love to play. They play ball and run along side by side. So here are Guru and Pichu, and it looks like they like to play and they play with the ball. Guru and Pichu go to their room to play. Pichu, don't make a mess in the house. Guru, take him outside, scolds a very angry mummy. So here is Guru's mother, and she's very angry that Pichu always makes a mess in the house and asks her son to take him outside to play. Guru and Pichu go outside to play. Guru, how much noise do you both make? Shh! Yells a very irritated Manohar uncle. So next, what do Guru and Pichu do? They go outside to play. But outside what happens? Manohar uncle shouts at them because they're making a lot of noise. Guru and Pichu go to the park to play. Guru, Pichu isn't allowed here. Come on, leave now. Shoo! Complains a very cranky Madhusudan Ajoba. So next what happens? They go to the park, but Pichu, the dog, isn't allowed in the park. And this is Madhusudan Ajoba. Madhusudan, grandpa, and he is angry. He is cranky. He is irritated. And he says, you have to go now. Where can we play, Pichu? Guru says sadly, staring at the sea. Oh yes, I know where we can go. So here are Guru and Pichu, and they are sad. They can't play at home, they can't play in the park, and they can't play outside. So where do they play? And then finally, Guru gets an idea when he is staring at the sea. Let's see what that idea is. Guru and Pichu go to the beach to play. Both Pichu and Guru stick their tongues out and gleefully enjoy the wind against their faces. No one says, Pichu, don't. No one says, Guru, take Pichu somewhere else. So here they are, Guru and Pichu, and they are having so much fun at the beach. And they're enjoying the wind against their faces, and nobody is yelling at them and telling them not to play there. Fetch, Pichu! Guru throws their red ball. The ball rolls towards the sea. Pichu runs after it, straight into the water. So what happens? When Guru is throwing the red ball, Pichu is just bringing it back every time. This time what happens? The ball rolls towards the sea and Pichu runs into the water chasing the ball. No, Pichu, don't go there. Come back, Guru yells. But Pichu's furry head is already disappearing into the water. So what happened? Pichu ran after the ball into the sea. And Guru is scared. He says, Pichu, come back. Don't go into the water. But Pichu's furry head is going under the water here. See? So what happens? Guru starts crying. Every memory with Pichu flashes before his eyes. So now Guru is crying because he thinks Pichu is gone under the water. He is drowned. He might be dead. And he thinks of all the fun he had with Pichu and he is crying. Bow bow. Pichu paddles through the water, proudly carrying the ball. Pichu, I didn't know you could swim, says Guru. Wow, wow, replies Pichu as if she always knew she could swim. So guess what happens? Pichu comes back out of the water with the ball and Pichu can swim in the water. So Pichu did not drown and she is still alive. So Guru is so happy to see Pichu. Guru and Pichu now go to the beach every day. They play ball. They run along side by side. They also play among the waves, jumping and splashing water at each other. So now that Guru knows Pichu knows how to swim, then he is not scared of taking Pichu to the beach every day. And that's where they play. They play with the ball, they run on the beach, and they also play in the water. I hope you enjoyed this story. Thank you. The difficult words in this story are cranky, in a bad mood, annoyed, gleefully, with joy. Try these questions. Where all do Guru and Pichu try to play? What happens at each place? Do you have a favorite place to play? Write about it.